I am a very independent and strong woman in history. There are many strong women in history, but I am the one and only Florence Nightingale. I am very important to modern sanitation and health. Like when you go to the hospital, it's not dirty. If you went to the hospital and you had a surgery in a dirty room, you might even die. I was born on May 12th in 1920. That makes me 197 this year. My dad taught me growing up, and he helped me learn to analyze data at 6 years old. My early life had a major effect on my accomplishments all throughout my entire life. Like when I would go to my friend Mary Clark's house, who was about 30 years older than me, but she would teach me many valuable things. My major accomplishments are things that I like to look back on and be proud of. Like when I was bestowed Order of Merit by King Edward, I was also the first woman to be bestowed Order of Merit. I helped make sanitation better in India by 17% without even leaving England. A little known facts are many things that people don't know about me, and I think they're fun to share with people. Like when I hand-reared an owl and rescued it from boys that were throwing stones at it to kill it. I named it Tiddles. I defied my parents, but it wasn't like when you go to a movie when you're supposed to be at school. I sailed to a different country when they didn't want me to. I went to Düsseldorf, Germany to study at Kaiserswerth Hospital. At least I got a good learning experience out of it. I attribute my success to this. I never gave or took any excuse. I said that when I was alive, because I died in 1920. You can be accomplished like me and many other people in history. Never doubt yourself and be your own inspiration.
Boys and girls, do you wonder why pilots are unstoppable? It's because of me. My name is Amelia Mary Earhart, and I was the first woman to do something amazing. I'm Amelia Mary Earhart, and I'm going to tell you how I became the first woman to fly across the Atlantic solo. I was born on July 24, 1897 in Atchison, Kansas. My mother's name was Amelia Otis Earhart, and my father's name was Samuel Sandy Earhart. I spent most of my childhood playing with my little sister Muriel, and I was homeschooled for most of my life. I saw my first plane at 10 years old, and I got my first taste of the sky at an air show on December 28, 1920, by pilot Frank Hawks. With my first flight that day, I realized my true passion was to fly, and so I began flying lessons with female avatar Nita Shook. My early life was pretty amazing. Childhood was cool, but now I'm going to tell you about my major accomplishments. On my 25th birthday, I purchased the Kenner Airster and flew it in an air show in 1922. When I set the woman's altitude record for 14,000 feet. As you heard earlier, I was homeschooled for most of my life, but after I finished high school, I went to a finishing school for girls, but didn't finish finishing. Instead, I became a nurse's aide in a Canadian military hospital during World War I. After that, in less than a year, I got my first pilot's license. In 1928, I was offered to be the first woman to fly across the Atlantic. But by first woman to fly, they meant just a woman sitting in a plane while somebody else flies it. After that, I was the first woman to receive the Air Force's Distinguished Flying Cross. Some of my major accomplishments were crazy, don't you think so? Some of my little known facts are crazy too. Remember when I told you about being the first woman to fly across the Atlantic but not solo or actually flying the plane? Well, I actually did get to fly across the Atlantic solo in 1928. There were some downfalls of flying over the Atlantic, though. I crashed on island Nukumaro and disappeared at the age of 39. Scientists had sights of my bones on the island, but they never really found my full body. They declared me dead on January 5th, 1938, at the age of 41. Although my story is sad, I'm happy of all the things that I've accomplished. And I've come back to tell my life story and how I became an inspiration to others. As I once said, women must try to do things as men have tried, but when they fail, their failure only becomes but a challenge to others. Thank you.
Hello. My name is Shirley Temple, and I came back from the dead to tell you some facts about me. So here are some facts about me that you might or might not know about me. You might know me as a singer, dancer, and actress, but there's a lot more to know about me. The first thing you need to know about me is my early life. I was born in Santa Monica, California, to a banker and a housewife with two older brothers. Another thing you need to know about me is I started my first Hollywood film when I was at age six. The first Hollywood film I starred in was called Carolina. The second thing you need to know about me is my major accomplishments. I had a lot of major accomplishments in my life. The first major accomplishment is when my song on A Good Ship Lollipop came out in the 1930s, it got famous and I earned a Special Academy Award. The second thing you need to know about me is I earned a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame in 1960. I hope you enjoyed some of my major accomplishments. The last thing you need to know about me is some little known facts about me. The first little known fact about me is that I had 56 curls on my head, and my mom did it for every movie, and there was always exactly 56 curls. Another thing you need to know about me is when I was 10 years old, like most of you are, I was at a barbecue, and I had a slingshot and a pebble. I put the pebble in the slingshot, and while Eleanor Roosevelt bent down to put her food on the grill, I pulled back the slingshot, and I let go, and it hit Eleanor Roosevelt right in the tush. I hope you enjoyed those funny and interesting little known facts about me. Oh no, look at the time. I best be on my way, but it was fun to share some of my facts with you. Here's one of my favorite quotes. Be brave, be clear, follow your heart, don't be overly influenced by outside factors, be true to yourself. I died at the age of 85, but I am one of the most remembered actresses, singers, and dancers.
Hello everyone, it's me, Helen Keller. What am I doing here, you ask? Now see, I'm bored. So therefore, I will be telling you a little about my past life. I hope you enjoy. First, I was born on June 27, 1880, born and raised in Alabama, Tuscumbia. Then when I was 2 years old, I became blind and deaf. Ann Sullivan taught me sign language when I was only 6 years old. Then when I was 8 years old, I became a celebrity with over 1 million fans. And then in 1900s, I went to Radcliffe College and finished in 1904. Here are some of my major accomplishments. I visited 39 countries and 5 continents because I considered myself a world citizen. And I was also the first blind and deaf person to graduate college. And I was great friends with Alexander Graham Bell and Mark Twain. I learned how to use Braille and wrote several books. One of them is Light in My Darkness in 1927. But sadly, on June 1st, 1968, I passed away at the age of 87. One of my quotes is, "The best and most beautiful things in the world cannot be seen or even touched. They must be felt with the heart." Well, I'm off to take a bigger journey. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Abraham Lincoln, and since I'm here, I'll tell you a little bit about my life. As you all know, I am the 19th President of the United States of America, and I lived in a small little cabin. But I'll tell you some stuff that you didn't know about me. As you know, I came from a time when slavery was around, but even though I was white, it still felt like I was put in slavery. Even though I get to see my family every day, but I didn't make any money. I had to give it to my dad, sadly. And I dropped out of law school because I just didn't really think it would be good for me. As you all know, I also lived in Kentucky. Sadly, my mom died when I was about a year old's age. Some major accomplishments of mine is that I started as farmer, then I became the President of the United States. I abolished slavery. That's good for everyone. I became the President of the United States of America. I kept the Congress from falling during the Civil War. And the most important one of all, I lived a very happy life. Some well-known facts about me is that when a Hawaiian Native American from the natives that lived there, I gave him golden watch to have the national anthem. And another one is that I took this medicine that made me very, very mad. And whenever I noticed side effects, I stopped taking it. And I'm messing up a little bit. I got elected 2 times. Now I must be going. I'll come back 1 time.
30 years.
Where in the heck am I?
Hi, I'm Eleanor Roosevelt, here to tell you about my life. I was nothing like the other first ladies. Back then, everybody knew me, and I'm hoping everybody will know me today. I was born October 11, 1884. My parents died when I was little. I lived with my grandmother since I was 8 years old. I had a very close relationship with Amelia Earhart. I got married in 1905 and had 6 children. Their names were Elliot, Franklin, Delano, Anne, James, John Roosevelt, and Franklin D. Roosevelt Jr. My husband was Franklin Roosevelt, if you can't already tell. He became president in 1933. That's also when I became first lady. I went to visit coal miners in 1935, and I also visited soldiers from World War II. I talked about human rights in front of 2,000 people. I was told I was a great first lady after Franklin became U.S. president. My husband died in 1945. I died in 1962. People called me First Lady of the World. I also lived alone for 17 years. People posted my quotes all over the cities. No one knew all of my quotes, but one was, "No one can make you feel inferior without your consent." I knew a bunch of things, like how people were being treated unfairly in other countries, so I tried to make that right. I also worked for the United Nations. In the end, after my first lady life, I was put in history for talking about human rights, visiting coal miners and soldiers, being first lady of the world, and many other things. My life as first lady was the best life I could ever ask for. Thank you for listening to me.
My name is Adam West. I want you to learn about my life. I have a lot of interesting facts about me, and I'm not in any books or plays. So let's get to it. I was born on September 19th, 1928. My father was a farmer, and my mother was a concert pianist and an opera singer. In 1943, when I was 15, I moved to Seattle with my mother, following and my parents divorced. I went to Lakeside High School. Went to Lakeside High School to finish my junior and senior years. I lived in Walla Walla before my parents divorced. And so I have a lot of early life facts about me. So one of my major accomplishments was getting a star on the Walk of Fame in 2012. In 2006, I got a Crime Stopper Duo Award with, I think, Burt Ward. And in 2005, I got the same award, but it was just for me, for being just a Crime Stopper. And in 2006, I got a TV Land Anniversary Award. So I have a lot of many major accomplishments in my life. Let's get into little known facts. I've been in 52 movies and TV shows combined. I've been acting for 48 years since 1959. My first TV show was in The Detectives in 1959. I've had 3 wives, Billy Yeager, Frisbee Dawson, I think, and Michelle, back in here. I have so many little known facts about me. So, in conclusion, I'm Adam West. My life's pretty amazing. I have so many accomplishments in my life. My life kind of isn't that famous. So I have so many possibilities. So, yeah, I'm Adam West.
Hello, I'm Alexander Hamilton, and I'm going to talk about my life. I was a writer, a journalist, and a statesman, and one of the founding fathers. I fought in the Revolutionary War, I was a hard worker, and I was right. I had a rough battle with General Washington, our leader, and I will always admire him. And my story goes on. I was born in January 11, 1757 in Charlestown. I had a family, but soon gone. My mother, Rachel Fawcett Buck, died because of a fever. My dad, James A. Hamilton, abandoned me, and I became an orphan. When I was 14, I started working for a trading company. I was very skilled and hardworking. Therefore, in 1772, the company sent me to college in North America. After college at Columbia University for 2 years, I joined the Army at the age of 18. However, after 2 years, Washington observed my leadership and skills. After, he sent me to AD camp, and I became Washington's most able and trusted aide in the Revolutionary War. In my late 20s, I wrote 51 out of 85 essays under the collected name of the Federalist Papers, and I started writing books, poems, and articles about my life. I was a veteran, a political intellectual, and an economist. In 1789, I became Secretary of the U.S. Treasury, and also helped pass a law that set up the first bank. I wrote a lot of books myself. I wrote The Full Vindication of the Measure of Congress, The Farmers Refuted, The Report on Manufactures, and many more. I died on July 4th, 1789, in a duel. I was a great man, in my opinion. I am still remembered today, and I know that I changed America so that we could have our freedom and peace. I am Alexander Hamilton, and I hope you enjoy.
Many people thought my life was perfect, but picture this, living in foster care with people abusing you, and a mom that is mentally unstable causing you to be in foster care, and a dad that you are unsure about. Well, that's how my life starts. When I was younger, my mom tried to murder one of her close friends with a knife, causing her to go to jail and me to go to foster care. My dad was never around at the time, and I never really got to see him. I had 11 sets of foster parents, and I had to move wherever they lived, and that was hard. Hi, my name is Marilyn Monroe. I was born on June 1st, 1926 in Los Angeles, California. I grew up in foster care because of my mom and dad. They also caused me not to have a very good education. My mom is mentally unstable, which means she is doing bad things, not even knowing she's doing them. My dad, I never really got to see. Some of my favorite accomplishments are the Golden Globe Award for Best Actress in 1960, 2 years before I died. Another one is the Golden Globe Hirta Award for World Film Favorites in 1954 and in 1962. In 1958, I won the David D. Donatello Golden Plate Award. I also had many movie accomplishments, like Sun Like a Hot in 1959 and Bus Stop in 1956. Some of my fun facts are that I was a comedian actress in some of my movies. In addition to that, if I did not die in 1962, I would be 91 years old today. One of my first husbands was my foster parent. His name was James Daugherty. He married me so I did not have to go back to foster care. If it wasn't for him, I would be 17 years old, still in foster care. I had plastic surgery on my face so nobody would call me ugly. Lastly, my real name is Norma Jean Baker. I told my women fans that women who seek to be equal with men lack ambition. Besides being famous, on August 5th, 1962, was my time to say goodbye forever. Still young and pretty, the accidental suicide from Barbara Richards' overdose from pills killed me at 36 years old. Sadly, I never got to see my dad, and now I'll never be able to. Always remember, live life the fullest and be responsible, because it can be really long or really short. Just depends on you.
Hi, My name is Carrie Fisher, and I'm going to talk about a little bit of myself today. But first, let's go with the basic facts. I always loved acting, writing books, and I really liked doing a lot of other things. You wouldn't have your favorite books or your movies without me either. And I did almost everything I could for your entertainment. My early life. I was born October 21st, 1956 in Burbank, California. I made appearances with my mom at a very young age. I was only 12 years old whenever I started making those appearances. These are some facts about my early life. My major accomplishments. I was most known as an actress, and one of my most famous movies is Star Wars. I starred as Princess Leia. I was also the top script doctor in Hollywood from 1991 to 2005. And if you don't know what a script doctor is, they do screenplays for other writers that, like, make mistakes or something so they can go over it. And I really hope all my accomplishments change the world. Here are some fun facts about me. I was actually a huge dog lover, and I thought that no dog should be hurt and they should be treated just the same as any other person. My dog Gary, I had a dog named Gary, and he was with me whenever I passed away. I was also a best-selling author. One of my most famous books was Postcards from the Edge. Now we can dive into the conclusion. I poured my heart into what I wanted to accomplish. Like Star Wars, there are thousands of actresses wanting to get the role of Princess Leia. So I had to work hard and I had to believe and I had to pour my heart into what I wanted to accomplish. And I hope the things I did on Earth, I want them to inspire you and know that anything is possible. I hope you enjoyed my speech.
I am Walt Disney. People know me as a dead person. Well, not really. I'm a famous animator. Here's where my legacy started out. I began my legacy on December 5th, 1901 in Chicago, Illinois. The other one opened when I was 17 in 1918. I tried out for the Army, but I was rejected for being underage. So I joined the American Red Cross, but they didn't really care how old I really was. Then, in 1928, I released Steamboat Willie, one of my smash hits. Others opened in 1932, my first award. It was an Academy Honorary Award. Since then, I've had other awards, like Primetime Emmy Awards, Golden Globes, many Academy, and Oscars. Lastly, a DJ Honorary Award in 1955. Time for a new topic, my facts, so let's get to it. I produced and animated Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, one of the first animated feature films ever. More on, I was actually the first voice of Mickey Mouse before the voice actors who play him today in TV and television and film. Originally, I intended to build a small amusement park near my studio in Burbank back then. My final fact for this speech is, my first office name back in the 20s was Laugh-O-Gram. In conclusion, I became a legacy because of all this and everyone else who helped. I died on December 15th, 1966. It was 10 days after I turned 65.
Good afternoon, guys. I'm from the past.
Yeah, that is crazy.
My name is Pat Summon. I'm going to tell you a little bit about myself. This is one of my favorite quotes I've ever said.
It is what it is, but it is what you make it.
I was born in Clarksville, Tennessee, the summer of 1952. My family moved to Henrietta, Tennessee, due to Clarksville not having a girls' basketball team. I'm in the Basketball Hall of Fame, the Naismith Hall of Fame. I won Coach of the Year 7 times.
and 8 national championships with my team, Tennessee. Abe Lincoln once said, whatever you are, be a good one. Hope y'all's a good mom slash coach. I have a son. His name is Tyler Summit. He is 27 years old. Luckily, he got to play at Tennessee too. I stepped down as coach in 2012 due to my Alzheimer's. My zodiac is Gemini. That means to be creative and open. Someone my coach made it to the WNBA. If you play basketball, maybe you will make it there too. Unfortunately, me and my husband made some very poor choices that forced us to get divorced in 2007. Even if something bad happens in your life, hopefully you can make it your own. Even though I died the summer of 2016, I feel and hope everything I've ever done in my life will be remembered forever. And remember, if you ever have something bad happen in your life, just make it your own, and everything will be just fine. See you all soon.
Hello, you all may not know me, but please picture this. Have you ever seen a tall man wearing normally a black suit with a big tall hat? Well, then if you do, you know what I look like. I'm Abraham Lincoln. Just because you know what I look like doesn't mean you know who I am. So I'm here today to give you a speech about who I was. And I'm also going to tell you a little bit about yourselves. Okay, first, my early life. I was born in 1809 on February 12th. In Hodgenville, Kentucky, and my siblings were Thomas, Sarah, and Gregory Lincoln. And when I was in my early 20s, like 21, I was a boatsman and a town clerk. Okay, now on to my major accomplishments. One, I was a politician and a lawyer, which kind of goes in with my early life, my jobs, and most known, I was the 16th president, and I ended slavery. I also led this country through the Civil War, thus kind of basically ending slavery. And I also gave the Gettysburg Address, which was a speech like I'm giving to you all today, which was in Gettysburg, Pennsylvania. Now on to a little known facts. I want to see if you guys really know this about me. Okay, so first, I was a huge animal lover. I would never really intentionally try to hurt an animal. I love them, and I believe that God put them on this planet for us to eat them, but not to harm them for no reason. And I actually don't have a middle name. That's the only reason why you hear Abraham Lincoln. Only two words, not some other third thing. And I was the one that made Thanksgiving a national holiday so that all of you could get together with your families and have dinner. And I didn't have any bad habits like smoking or drinking or dipping, because I believe that we should be true men and not have any bad habits like that. Okay. And also, you all may not know this, but I was born in 1809, as you all know, but if you look at a penny today, you'll see that it has my face on it. But did you know the first time they ever put my face on it was 1909, celebrating my birthday of 100 years old, of me being 100 years old. And also, here's a fact about one of you. Long time ago, I don't know when it was, but I actually had lunch with one of your grandfathers, like great times three grandfather. I don't know where he is. Oh, his name was Mr. Edwin Atwater, and his grandson, I don't know, his name is Gage. Maybe he's in the bathroom, I don't know, but now towards the end, I hope that you've learned a lot about me. I've learned that you guys are great listeners, and I just want you to know that you can do anything, because I used to dream of doing big things, and look, I did them. So I just want you to know that you can do anything that you put your mind to.
Hi. Imagine new singer beside me creating the first ever Tesla coil. I was known as the mentor of the century, and my name is Nikola Tesla. I had a very rare, unusual early life, and I was born in a little place called Cotija, where I eventually took a trip to America and stayed there when I was 12. I worked for Thomas Edison in his building, from cleaning up his office to powering the engines that powered the building. That was about my early life. I also had some major accomplishments. As you might not know, I created the Tesla coil, which was used for cars for vibration techniques. Also, I got a lot of medals, including the John Scott Medal and the University of Paris Medal. Those were some things about my major accomplishments. Here's some things that you may not know about me. Originally, I was going to be a Serbian priest, but when I had a disease in high school, my dad said that if I survived, I could pick any college that I wanted to go to. Also, when I worked for Thomas Edison, he made a joke about promising me a large amount of money, which would cost around $70,000 in today's money. And when I did the thing that he said that he was joking, considering that I didn't understand American humor. Another one that you may not know was I had a very weird, unusual fear of pearls. Whenever I would see pearls, like on necklaces or just random jewelry, I would freeze and just fall to the floor sometimes. Those were some things that you may not know about me. Here's my conclusion. I once said, I have not failed, I have just found 10,000 reasons that have not worked. I was a very overlooked hero, and I do not want to be overlooked anymore. Let me not be overlooked anymore. Yeah.
Hello, my name is Princess Diana. Today you'll be learning about me. About my early life, my major accomplishments, and little-known facts. My maiden name is Diana Frances Spencer, and I was born in the Spencer family of British nobility. And when I was young, I was the youngest in the family. I lived on Park House City, Sandusky Hills, and educated in England and Switzerland. When I was 7, my parents had a divorce. I was associated with lots of charities and fought landforms. And in 1988, I went to the first patchroom Chester Childbirth Appeal. In 1987, I paid a world visit to openings of a new charity, and I was the first person to touch someone with AIDS with no gloves. I was born July 1st, 1967, and died August 31, 1997. My father, Edward John the 8th Earl Spencer, that was his name. I hope you learned something new, and I hope you enjoyed, and that was my life.
Hello, fellow students and families. I'm here to talk about me. My family were known as famous people. My mom is a singer, and my dad is an actress. My name is Carrie Fisher. Next, I became an actor and I've heard so many movies. I smoke and they should not do. Also, I do drugs that I should not do also. My mom is Debbie Reynolds. That was her name before she got married. Now it's Debbie Fisher. One of my accomplishments is so many movies that saw Star Wars and more. And another one is I stopped smoking. Also, I stopped doing drugs. I made a book with my own two hands, and you should go really look at it. I died in December 27th. Before that, my age was 60. and my date of birth is this October the 27th. I don't want my life to be limited to art. I want my life to be art.
Hello, I am George Washington. I have come to tell you about my early life major accomplishments, little known facts, etc. I had two children. They came to live with me. So did Martha, too. I had been brought to this world in 1732 and had left 1799. I lived in Mount Vernon. The area is 500 acres. I was first president, as you may know. I helped form the USA we know today. And we also beat Great Britain. My father was Augustine Washington. He had been born in 1694 and had left 1743. I had received a hatchet for my birthday and had chopped down my father's cherry tree. And he thought my forgiveness was more than 1,000 trees. I was a surveyor of land surveying. Surveying is a technique of profession and science. Thank you for listening to my life story. I hope you know a little more about it.
Have you ever been asked who was the youngest and long-lived of the Titanic? Well, I know, and you're looking at her, just to tell you. It's Melvina Dean. I'm a teenager right now. Life was really bad during the Titanic times. It was hard to work around, though. I boarded the Titanic when I was 2 months old. I don't like when people look at my father's grave, even though he died during the Titanic when it sank. My mom told me that I was really scared. Would you be scared? I was the youngest out of 705 survivors. If everyone lived, that would be way too much. I was 9 months old when the Titanic sank. I had no one to look forward to yet, but I never will, probably. I used to have torn clothes when I was very little. I don't like water, because it has no taste. If any questions, please look on Google. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Helen Keller, and I'll be talking to you about my life. I was born in Alabama in June 1880. At 19 months old, I got sick. It was a scarlet fever or meningitis. Then at 6 years old, I became blind. I got an illness. I was deaf. I lived on a big farm called Ivy Green. My parents got me a teacher at around 7 years old. She taught me how to read American and Braille. At eight, she took me to a Perkins school. Here's my early life. I learned Braille and American. What did I do for a birthday gift? I wrote a book, The Frost King, in 1891. I won a Presidential Medal of Freedom for President Lyndon Johnson. I wrote over 25 plus books. One of them is called The Frost King. I finished college in 1904. I worked at a American Foundation with Anna Sullivan. I visited a blind, deaf, and disability soldiers in World War II. I also worked at a military hospital. How did I die? I died in my sleep on June 1st of 1968. This was my life. Thank you for listening. Do you have any questions? Wow.
Hello, my name is Clara Burton. Today you get to learn more about me and my life. First, we get to learn about the Red Cross. helping others and my family. Hope you enjoy. I was the youngest of five siblings, four kids. I was born on Christmas Day, 1821. I had a huge family. I love school and I love reading books. Now you get to learn about the Red Cross. I started the Red Cross because people wouldn't take me as a nurse. Saving people was a big part of my life. Helping others was another big part of my life. I loved helping animals when at the age of 10, and I also saved my brother. Also, at the age of 17, when I first finished college, I became a teacher. At the age of 28, because of respect problems. Sadly, and then the war came. Now, here's a little bit more about me I don't think you know. I loved riding horses. I saved over 22,000 people from the war. I loved to joke around. Thanks for listening. Now you know a little bit more about me.
Hi, my name is Walt Disney. I was born in 1901. I started drawing by copying front page cartoons. I was a cartoonist at my high school. My first job was a commercial artist in Pezman Rubin when I was 18. I moved to Hollywood in 1923. I started the Disney Company with my brother Roy. My wife's name is Lillian. We have two daughters, Diane and Sharon. Mickey Mouse started as Mortimer Mouse in 1928. I was his voice until 1947. I have a record number of awards, 25 Academy Awards, 3 Golden Globes, and 1 Emmy. Disneyland opened in 1955. The trash cans are equally spaced because that's how long it takes for somebody to eat a hot dog. I died in 1966. Of lung cancer because I smoked. I was 65 years old. I'm known as entrepreneur. And an animator and voice actor and a film producer. I am a cultural icon. The end.
Good afternoon, students. I'm Queen Elizabeth I, the Queen of England. I would like to share information about myself, including early life, major accomplishments, and little known facts. Be prepared to be blown away. Let me start off by saying, first, I was born September 7th, 1533. I was born at Greenwich Palace in London. Also, I was never meant to be queen. How silly does that sound? The reason why I was never meant to be queen is because my brother died of tuberculosis and my sister only lasted 5 years as queen. I was just a normal royal kid at the time. Here were some of my major accomplishments. I could speak several different languages, including Latin, Greek, French, Spanish, and Welsh. Also, I was the longest ruling monarch of the UK. I ruled for 44 years. I was in a world that was male dominated and proving that I could rule just as well as a man. Lots of people don't know facts about me, so I'll give you some now. Accordingly, I took the throne at a very early age, and earlier than most people would expect. I took it at 25. On another note, I died at a really early age. I died at the age of 69. There are tons more little facts where that came from. Sadly, I died March 24th because of blood poisoning. Thank you for listening to my speech. I hope you realized how I changed our community, country, and world. Thank you.
it is me, Marilyn Rue, and today I'll be talking to you a little bit about my life. I starred in over 20 movies, 6 songs, and 24 modeling pictures. I was also in over 6 big awards. My big quote is in the Netflix original series, Pretty Little Liars, in season 5. It was, "Give a girl the right pair of shoes and you can conquer the world." I died at age 36. I spent almost all my life in Los Angeles, California, and in Hollywood. I was born June 1st, 1926, Norma Jean. I was in over 10 orphanage and foster homes, and then Gladys Pearl Baker picked me up, which made me Norma Jean Baker. My siblings she also picked up were Bernice and Robert Baker, and my early life dream was to be a lawyer. I got $120 a week with my 20th Century Fox contract, which is actually a lot in normal time. I was marked as one of the prettiest girls in history, and my first modeling gig was in my last year of college. I got a master's degree in criminal justice, and I died over overdose with pills and medicine. I waited 2 years before acting, watching other actors on set so I could know how to do it properly. Before I was Marilyn Monroe, I wanted to be Adora Jean. I sang happy birthday to John F. Kennedy, and the dress that I wore was $450, which now it is over $100,000 because of I was in it and it had diamonds. Hope you enjoyed this biography. One thing you can learn from me is hard work pays off and never give up. Rihanna and Mariah Carey both said that I was their role models, and hope you guys enjoyed this biography.
Hello, my name is Judy Garland, and today I'll be telling you a little bit about myself. I was born on June 10th, 1922 in a small town called Grand Rapids, Minnesota, which grew up over the years to become a big part of Minnesota. And whenever I was little, I was very crafty, so I wanted to be a painter. And whenever I was 13, I got an official contract with MGM, which is a singing and acting company, and of course I was 13 at the time, like I've told you, and I thought it was a gigantic mistake, which I got over it because I had horrible stage fright and some major things that have happened in my life have been I won 13 trophies. Some of them were from Grammys, some of them were from other places. And I lost 10 trophies, sadly, and a lot of things. And I had 2 jobs, which was singing and acting because of MGM, which I'm pretty sure is still alive today. And over a lot of years, at least over Earth, at this amount, a million people have watched The Wizard of Oz. And I had 3 children, Joey, who is 71, and Loma, who is 64, and Liza, who is 62. And I had my own TV show called The Judy Garland Show, which was my last TV show I actually played in, which it was kind of like a reality show because it gone along with like my life and all that. And the age that I got married is at the age of 35. And I died by a drug overdose and at the age of 47. And that's it. And kids, please don't do drugs.
Hello, I'm Christina Green. Today I'm here to tell you about me. First, I'm going to start off by saying I'm a singer. I was born March 12, 1994, and I died June 10, 2016. I was 22 years old. In my early life, I had 9 singles released. I was the host of Power Up in 2012. I went to Cherokee High School. I was on season 6 of The Voice and got 3rd place. The frontman for Maroon 5 coached me. Some of my little known facts were I went on tour with Rachel Platten once and Selena Gomez twice. I was shot by Kevin James Global. After being shot twice, my brother tackled him so he wouldn't harm anyone else. But he broke me, ran outside, went up against the wall, and shot himself. That was after my concert in Orlando, Florida. I'm going to tell you a few more facts.
I play drums and guitars. I was a YouTube star in high school. I released my first record at 17 years old. Hope you enjoyed.
My fellow students and teacher, I am here to talk about the history of me, Benjamin Franklin, inventor of life. I was born in January 1706, and I was the 15th child of my family. I came from a large family. My mom had 17 children. When I was 12 years old, I worked at a print shop with my older brother, and then I moved to Philadelphia to write the Poor Richard's Almanac. Most people know me as the person who discovered electricity. Speaking of electricity, I also invented the lightning rod. So what the lightning rod is the lightning attracts to the rod so that it could protect houses from power outages. I was one of the founding fathers of the U.S. I also asked France to help me in the Revolutionary War, and they did, and we won because of them. I was a member of the American Chess Hall of Fame, and I also invented the glass harmonica. My design of it was so unique that Beethoven, Stratus, and Mozart composed pieces to it. I invented bifocals. These are types of glasses that you can see out of in two ways. One, reading, and two, seeing long distances. Either write things worth the reading or do things worth the writing. Well, this is Benjamin Franklin signing out.
My name is John Wilkes Booth. You may know me as the man who killed the 16th President, Abraham Lincoln. But I'm more than just the man who killed him. Well, I am the man who killed him. But I was an actor, quite a popular one, too. You will learn about that more in detail later. So I guess this brings us to my early life. My father was an actor. He played across the state in a occasionally across the country. He died when I was only 14, and when I turned 17, around that time, I decided to become an actor myself. That brings me on to my major accomplishments, which is mainly around acting. I was very popular, played in Shakespeare plays such as Romeo and Juliet and Hamlet. I was so popular that when I was walking out of the theater to go to my hotel, some people were waiting for me and they started tearing off my clothes. Somebody had to tell them to stop. After that, sometime later, I made headlines saying, "Most promising actor of that time." But a little known fact about me is that after I shot President Abraham Lincoln's in the head, I jumped onto the stage and broke my ankle after I said something. Me and like five other people ran away and had a doctor fix my ankle. After we crossed the river, they got caught. They cornered me into a barn. One of the police officers saw me through a crack in one of the boards, so they shot me somewhere in the neck here, and they paralyzed me from the neck down. And they just drug me onto the barn on this porch. That's pretty stupid, being that people don't really have anything to do with the dead body, right? That's some little known facts about me. But to conclude, I'd like to say that hopefully you know me now as more than just the man who killed the 16th President Abraham Lincoln. I was an actor, not a murderer. Thank you.
Hello, my fellow classmates. I am Theodore Roosevelt, but many people know me as Teddy. I am the 26th President of the United States of America, and I have an interesting story to tell you. I was born October 27, 1858 in New York. As a child, I struggled with asthma. So at the age of 12, my father challenged me to do boxing and gymnastics. I guess I had a normal life as a child. For my major accomplishments, I served 2 terms as vice president under William McKinley, and then after his assassination, I became president. I also won the Nobel Peace Prize. In fact, I was the very first politician in the world to win it. Guess I did a whole lot in my life. Some stuff that people don't know about me is I was the youngest president in history to become president. I was in a boxing match during my presidency and got blind in the left eye. I was versing against a Navy soldier. Both my mother and wife died on the same Valentine's Day. I helped organize and was a member of the Rough Riders. Let me finish off by saying, you and me can accomplish many things. It's not hard if you put your mind to it. Like I once quoted, believe in yourself, you're halfway there. Let my life be inspiration to yours.
Hello, my name is Will Chairman. I'll be telling you a few things about myself. For one, I was born on August 21st, 1936, and I was the first NBA player to ever score 30,000 in my career. I retired basketball in 1964. I am 7'1", and I joined the Lakers, and I usually scored 44 in a game. I was a billionaire. Just to put that out, I was bluntly a billionaire. And Shaquille O'Neal stole my, like, kind of, like, used my name. He used my name as his nickname, the Wilter, close to that. And if you ever want to learn more, just ask me, anybody, and thank you for listening.
Who sang till death? Who was the one who showed to be strong? And who was the one who was just born to sing? Hi, my name is Joey Feith, and today I'm here to speak to you a little bit about what my life is like here on my time on Earth. I was a mother, a wife, and a singer. I led a very eventful life. Of all things, music has always been my main passion. Just give me a guitar, and you're ready to sing. I had a good childhood. I was born September 7, 1975 in Alexandria, Indiana, in a small farming community. My parents were Jean and Jack, who were both basically inclined. Doing things like harvesting crops or taking care of the animals a lot of times inspired me to write or even sing music. I also accomplished many different things. My first album became a top 40 hit on Hot Country Songs. Soon the album became number 10 on top country albums and number 61 on top 200. Me and my husband Rory won Academy of Music Awards, Top New Vocal of the Year, and soon later in 2011, won Inspirational Country Music Awards category Vocal Duets. You may be thinking, it's pretty cool guy with all these awards, but of all things, even with these other awards that I am proud of, nothing can top off the birth of my daughter, Tiana. There's also some things you may not know about me, like I met my husband Rory in 2002 at the Bluebird Cafe in Nashville. Soon we tied in a love knot and married June 15, 2002, the same year we met. I was diagnosed with cancer June of 2014, and I did many different treatments. At one point, we thought we'd beat it, but eventually it came back. After several more failed treatment, I decided to go back home to my farm and live the rest of my days out with my family. And I died March of 2016. Nobody can stand me. I will still climb the stairs of faith, even if I may just be dead. I've gone from start to finish, not knowing to go left or right, or to walk or run. I've basically danced across time, not trying to make the right moves at the right time. I've always loved singing, and I still sing today in for the heavenly world, but it's just for a different audience. Wow.
Hi, I'm Abraham Lincoln, and I'm the 16th president. I helped the country by freeing the slaves. Now, I have a wife named Mary Ann Todd, and also, I have 4 kids.
Now, let's talk about my early life. My mother and father were regular old parents, but when I was 9 years old, my mother died of food poisoning. What I lived in was a one-room cabin in Illinois when I was 7 years old. Who I got married to when I was 21 was Mary Ann Todd in Illinois. Now, some of my major accomplishments is obviously being the 16th president, and also is being an assassination, which an assassination is when you're being killed unknowingly. Also, before my assassination, I created the Secret Service hours before. Also, I created something called a patent. A patent is something in a room when you have a flood in your room, in a room, and an air chamber opens up and it floods out the water. Little known facts is I was a wrestler in the Hall of Fame in high school. Also, in I think 2000, coffin robbers came and wanted to take me away somewhere, but unfortunately, they didn't get away with it. Well, not unfortunately, but they didn't get away with it. Also, 8 years later, more coffin robbers came and tried to do the same, but unsuccessfully. Thank you for listening. I would also like to thank you for keeping your eyes on me for the most of the part. Thank you.
Hello, have you ever heard of me?
No,
I did not tell you my name. I am Babe Ruth. I played baseball before everyone here was born. I was a pitcher and an excellent hitter. And then I once said, every strikeout brings me closer to the next home run. I was born in 1895 in Baltimore. At 7, I went to St. Mary's Industrial School for Boys. There were very strict rules at the school. Some of my major accomplishments were, I joined the Boston Red Sox in 1914. Also, that was where I won the 1915, 16, and 18 World Series. In my career, I won 7 World Series. And I joined the Baseball Hall of Fame in 1936. Also, I played for the Yankees in 1920 and 1934. I thought I was 1 year older than I really was. And I was 5, so I was 5 in 1900, not 6. I spoke German in my childhood, and also once I pitched 14 innings in a postseason game, which is the record. As you can see, my childhood I spoke German. It's one of the best baseball players in the history, and I was one of the best hitters, or the best hitter ever. I had a great career, and I wonder if you can do great in what you do. Do you think you can?
Hello, I am Hans Christian Andersen. There is little known about myself, so I will tell you about me. Today, I will talk about my early life, my major accomplishments, and little known facts. I'm very excited to tell all of you. And so, let's get started. Now I'm going to talk about my early life. I was born April 2nd in 1805 in Odense, Denmark, and I died on August 8th in 1816 in Copenhagen. My dad, Hans Andersen Sr., died in 1816 when I was 11 years old. I have just talked to you about my early life. Now I'm going to talk about my major accomplishments. I met important people like Charles Dickens in April of 1816. I made 156 fairy tales like The Snow Queen, The Little Mermaid, The Princess and the Pea, and Thumbelina, which I originally named Inchelina. I just talked to you about my major accomplishments. Now I'm going to talk about my little known facts. I have dyslexic, a disease which means that you can't read or spell properly, but I was able to learn how to read. I had a soprano voice, which means I could sing very high, and I was accepted into the Royal Danish Theatre because of that. I just talked to you about my little known facts. I have given information to all of you about myself in this time, and I am glad that I got to share it. I hope you can use this information in essays, speeches, and papers, if you would like to. One more thing. Life itself is the most wonderful fairy tale. So boys and girls, enjoy it. Goodbye!
Flight. Well, men hardly dreamed of because those who did were thought of as fools. Those who did were considered as dreamers. Ever since childhood, I was one of those dreamers. My name is Orville Wright, and this is my life story. It all started in 1871, where Bishop Wright and his wife anxiously await the arrival of their youngest son, me. The youngest child's spot was soon taken by my younger sister, Catherine, of course. When me and my very close brother, Wilbur, were hanging around, our father came home with an amazing new toy, a helicopter, which immediately inspired us about flight. Little did we know that small inspiration led to our success. Despite our multiple businesses such as a bike shop, a printing shop, and a newspaper, the dream of flight still remained in the back of our minds. Me and Wilbur started making many experimental test gliders and flew them in Kitty Hawk, North Carolina. Then we made one with a motor, and it flied. I flied like a bird in the sky, graceful and free. Me and my brother had accomplished our dream dreams. Though I'm best known for the Wright Flyer, there's still many things to know about me. Like when her mother was diagnosed with tuberculosis, Wilbur had to quit school to help her. She sadly passed away, and just as a hint, I never finished school either. Another interesting fact is I launched a career of an African-American poet. And just as a disclaimer, me and Wilbur never dated, never. But the coolest fact to highlight all of these, Neil Armstrong brought with him a piece of the Wright Flyer to the moon. Not to brag, but I think I had a pretty interesting life. In 1948, I sadly passed away. A quote I said was, "We always worked together. We did our best work together." And it's true, if it wasn't for Wilbur, we would never be the Wright brothers everyone knows today. So if you have a dream, don't be afraid to try. With a net made of perseverance and hard work, me and Wilbur caught our dream of dreams. So the question I stand here and ask you today, how you catch your dream of dreams. Thank you.
Me, Christiane Grimmie, here to tell my story. So first of all, I was born on March 12th, 1994. I was very famous. I had a lot of fans on YouTube and just in general. Have you heard of me? If you haven't, I'm here to tell you my story. This is all you need to know about my early life. I grew up in Malton, New Jersey. I attended Bethel Baptist Christian School, Malton Middle School, and Karaoke High School. And I was also brought up as a Christian. I started singing when I was 6. I started taking piano lessons when I was 10. That's all you need to know about my early life. Some major accomplishments that I earned in my life were, I was selected to be on The Voice. I was a singer, songwriter, and pianist. I was YouTube famous. Some of the songs that I sang was, My most favorite song that I sang was I Won't Give Up, and some of the other ones was I Can't Help Falling in Love, Apologize, Hello, and Tell My Mama. In 2010, after the cover video Party in the USA, I became a YouTube hit when I was only 16 years old. In 2013, I placed third in season 6 of The Voice. In 2016, I embarked on a tour with Rachel Platten. Some little known facts about me are that my mom's name was Tina, my dad's name is Albert, and I only have one sibling. His name was Marcus. And Tina worked as a receptionist until she got diagnosed with breast cancer. Albert worked at Verizon, and Marcus served as my road manager for my performances. My favorite video game was Legend of Zelda. I was self-described as a goofy goober. I was a dog person only because I was allergic to cats. And that's some little-known facts about me. It's all you need to know about my early life, major accomplishments, and little-known facts. I hope you enjoy. Well, here's some extra. I was murdered by Kevin Lullaby. I was shot and I died June 10, 2016. I was very missed by friends and family, and I got onto The Voice. I was very famous, and I was very well. Hope you enjoy.
My name is J.R.R. Tolkien. I'm a writer that did more than write and a teacher that did more than teach. I was bitten by a baboon spider in the garden when I was fairly young, and my dad died shortly after when I was only 4. I hated many books, including The Pied Piper of Treasure Island, and found that Alice's Adventures in Wonderland was amusing yet disturbing. I created many books myself, including The Silmarillion, The Hobbit, and Lord of the Rings. I also tried out some poetry, such as A Grand Tree. I won many awards for what I had written, such as the Gandalf Grand Award and the Locust Award for Best Fantasy Novel. My full name is John Ronald Reuel Tolkien. I got my middle name Reuel from my father, who died with the same thing that I died with, rheumatic fever, on January 3rd, 1892. I'm a Roman Catholic who created languages for fun, and I taught at the same college I went to. Thank you.
Hello, I am John Adams. Forgot the name, you may not know me. I am the second president of the United States. I have come here to tell you about myself. I received a full scholarship to Harvard when I was yet the young age of 16. I signed the Declaration of Independence, and I became the second president of the United States of America. I met George Washington being his vice president. Moving on to my early life, I was a prodigy and went to Harvard, as I said before. A prodigy is someone who excels in a certain area. My real birthday is October 19th. But the U.S. changed calendars, making it October 30th. I have several major accomplishments, one of which is I was the second president of the United States of America. I became the first president to live in the White House due to the fact that we did not finish building it when George Washington was president. And I was the first vice president. I fought during the Revolutionary War, but I did not kill anyone. I was a pacifist. You may know me in some more ways, but there are some little known facts about myself, including I was a school teacher for 5 years before I became a lawyer. Most people believe I just let Thomas Jefferson sign the Declaration of Independence, but no, I drafted him after he becoming my vice president. And for my conclusion, I'd like to say, just because I was remembered as a rude person that not a lot of people know, doesn't mean you can't be remembered for something great and excellent. And finally, I'd like to say, democracy, well, it lasts more bloody than either eracostery or monarchy. It soon wastes, exhausts, and murders itself. Remember, there's never been a democracy that did not commit suicide.
My name is Audrey Hepburn, and I have used the body of your fellow classmate today to tell you about myself, my major accomplishments, how I survived World War II, and my two pesky brothers. Let me tell you about when I was young. My father left me when I was very young. Therefore, my brothers had a different last name. I started acting when I was very young. When I was only 22, I was on Broadway. My memory is a little foggy, but I think it was the production of Gigi. My early life was different than most, but I wouldn't trade it for the world. When I was alive, I accomplished many things. As you know, I am an actress, starring in Breakfast at Tiffany's. I work for the United Nations International Children's Emergency Fund, mainly because of World War II. Major accomplishments in my life were plentiful.
Let me tell you some things you may not have known about me. My true name is Audrey Kathleen Rustin. I use my stepfather's name as my stage name. I had cancer. Consequently, I died at age 64. I hope you learned some little-known facts about me. I have to leave soon. My potion is wearing off. I hope you learned about my early life major accomplishments, and don't forget those little-known facts. You can conduct your own research about me. And when you think Hollywood star, remember Audrey Hepburn.
Whoa, what just happened?
What?
What?
What? My name's Madison. Do you all know me? What?
Hello, my name is Martin Luther King, and I was a pretty good speaker as an adult because when I was in college, I got a C in my books. I tried to stop racism and change other people's opinion, but I knew it would never be stopped. I was born in a cooped-up house in Atlanta, Georgia, and my father taught me the manuscript. I had two brothers and one sister, and when my mom died, I thought about committing suicide. I won the Nobel Prize for my winning speech, I Have a Dream. I also delivered about 450 speeches and led 7 marches and supported 1 with college church leaders. I also met famous people like Rosa Parks, Malcolm X, and Muhammad Ali. I died at about 35 years old and my heart was 60 years old. I was a heavy smoker. In conclusion, I would like to say a motto. If you can't fly, run. And if you can't run, walk. And if you can't walk, crawl. But whatever you do, just keep on moving. And I definitely kept moving.
Hello, I'm known as Mark Twain. I was a craftsman, author, and worker. I was an encouragement to all. My name is Samuel Langhorne Clemens, and I was one of the greatest writers of all time. I had an interesting early life. I was born on November 30th, 1835, in Florida, Missouri, to Jane Lampton and John Clemens. In 1958, I became a licensed young river pilot along the Mississippi River. When I was 4 earlier, I had moved to Hannibal, Missouri. And slavery was currently outlawed there, so that gave me many ideas about race and slaves to write about. I had an interesting childhood. I also had a big variety of accomplishments. In 1869, I published my first book, The Innocents Abroad. And later, I published The Adventures of Tom Sawyer. And right before that, I had to give speeches around the country to get money. This was due to an inventor delivering my typewriter very late, and I didn't have enough money to pay taxes. I'm mighty proud of my accomplishments. There are many things you don't know about me. Here's a start. When I was a river pilot, my career was stopped abruptly by the Civil War, and I was briefly a soldier in the Confederate Army. I also prefer to be photographed in white suits. And the day I was born and the day I died, the Halley's Comet was in the sky. This is amazing because it comes about every 76 years. Now you know all these things. I hope you learn more about my life. And I died about a century ago. And I once said, kindness is a language the deaf can hear and the blind can see. I was right. I'm going to live by that. What about you?
Hello, my name is Steve Jobs. I co-founded Apple and I was a CEO. I have made many great things such as the iPhone and iPod, but I'm here to make it even better. It won't need chargers or Wi-Fi. It'll be easy to use and quick to set up. But before I get into that, here's a bit of my early life. My parents were very fond of me because I was adopted. My adopted dad's job was a Coast Guard, while my mom's was an accountant. Well, my adopted mom was an accountant. But at school, I was a really bad kid. I pulled pranks and pulled really mean tricks. But I still had great grades because of my adopted dad always taught me about technology, so I was really good. So when I was in elementary school, they asked if I should go to high school to study there, but my parents declined. But here are some of my accomplishments. I was a shareholder of Pixar. I also was fired from Apple and started a company for Station Computers. I also have some award-winning animations, which were Monster Inc., Toy Story, and Incredibles. Also, my real parents were graduate students. My dad's job was a science professor, while my mom's was a speech therapist. But I also deciphered FBI files too. But after all that, here's my conclusion. A lot of people are good at something, like writing, art, or drawing, but if you just keep working on it, you will succeed. Like how I kept on working on technology, you will succeed as well, like how I did. And you might be rich and famous as well. But after all that, I am done with this.
Hello, my name is Albert Einstein, and if you do not know much about me, I am here to tell you. When I was born in 1879, my head was a very weird shape, and my parents were scared for my future and always thought I would be a slow learner because of it. I had one wife, Olivia Merrick, and was divorced and married my cousin, Elsa Lowenthal. We had three kids, two sons and one daughter. I invented the fridge, not necessarily the fridge, but a heat pump that I called the Einstein refrigerator. I split the atom to help make the atomic bomb. I was a professor at the Berlin Academy of Science. I won the Nobel Prize. I never combed my hair or wore socks. When I was stuck on physics, I would play the violin. I had three kids. My cause of death in 1955 was abdominal aortic aneurysm.
Hello, my name is Steve Jobs. You know me because of Apple. When people buy my devices, it makes me feel like I've changed the world for the better. But I want to tell you more about me. You know, I'm more than just CEO of Apple. I was born February 24, 1955, in San Francisco, California, in Silicon Valley. I have adoptive parents. As a kid, I was bullied. One day, I came home from school, and I got so sick and tired of getting bullied. I told my parents if they didn't let me move schools, I would quit school forever. This is only a chunk of things I did in my life. I have many major accomplishments. My biggest one made me a legend. I passed before my biggest accomplishment, but my biggest major accomplishment was the iPhone 6. Now that I'm back, I see the 6 is better than the 7. Because of the 7 not having the headphone jack. That's what made a difference between the 6 and the 7 being different. As you can see, the iPhone 6 made me famous. I have many well-known facts. I am a vegetarian, and I saved animals. I got praised by the PETA. I also saved Pixar. Disney bought Pixar for me, which, in conclusion of that, made me Disney's largest shareholder. As you can see, I'm very surprising. As you all know, my name is Steve Jobs. I realized when I said something about my devices making me happy, that is wrong. When people that know me and surround me and call my name, not just CEO of Apple, that makes me truly happy. I hope you enjoyed it.
Hi, I'm Daniel Boone, and I'm here to give you a history lesson about my life so far. I was born on November 2nd, and I have 10 siblings. And I've already traveled by myself from Pennsylvania to Kentucky. As a child, I loved exploring. I was always going around town just seeing what I could see. And at age 12, the Indians of the town taught me survival. Also at age 12, I got my first gun. It was a rifle. Now that I'm older, I think I've done many great things in life. Although my family isn't as wealthy as they could be, so I could go on a military trip to support that and help them. Much is known about me, but I have a few secrets. Like, it takes a long time for me to build or create something. I secretly named my gun that I got at 12 years old Tick Licker, because I could shoot a tick and it would be dead. That accurate. And when I die, I think that my family will mess up my gravestone because they can be a little weird sometimes. So overall, I think I was a good citizen. I went through problems, I pushed through them though. Traveling was scary, but I had my little dog along my side as we set out for greatness in open land.
Hi, my name is Will Chamberlain. I was born on August 21st, 1936. I went to high school, and my high school name was Shoemaker Junior High. I scored 2,200 points in an NBA season, and I was 6'11 in height. One of my nicknames was Will the Stove. I did not like this nickname because it was from a local reporter, and he kept on using it every time. Now let's talk about my early life. Like I said, I went to Shoemaker Junior High. I also grew up playing on the playgrounds and with some older kids, and they taught me a lot about the game. I went to the University of Kansas. In high school too. I got the name the Big Dipper. I did like that. That was like my favorite nickname that I had. I got it from my friends, and when I had to duck through a doorway, because like I was so tall every time I got through it. Some of my major accomplishments in my life was I had an 100-point game. That was like my most famous one. I also had a 2,000 rebound season, and in college I averaged 50 or more points a game. I also dunked on a 12-foot goal when I was at Kansas. Some little known facts about me is that I acted in a movie. I beat Muhammad Ali in a boxing match. I was a big volleyball fan, and I played volleyball in high school and some in college. I was in some magazines, and I wrote some books. Well, hopefully you learned something about my life. Obviously, I was a basketball player. I also outboxed Muhammad Ali. I love volleyball, and I played volleyball. I was in some books and some movies, and hopefully now you know about my life. Bye.
Hello there, my name is Dr. Seuss, and I am a freelance writer in Pennsylvania. My parents and I moved to North America in 1881. My parents put me in a school called Fox Origin. After the year of Fox Origin, I went to college, and I left college in 1882 because I never got my diploma. In 1883, I met a girl named Haley. We met at the library, but sadly, she died in 1884 by assassination. In 1888, I married a girl named Diamond. And it's like the same thing again. We met at the library again. And in 1891, I died of oral cancer.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Captain Smith, and I want to tell you all about my life and tell you about who I was and what I did before before I became a captain. So before I was born, I had 25 members of the family tree. And ever since I had the job, the remains that I got was, that people got for me, was my badge and my hat. And apparently lots of people think that I was some kind of like salesman, but no. Okay, I just have this question for you. Who went fishing with their family member before? I went fishing with my dad, and apparently when I got a letter saying that about the new cruise ship, the RSS Titanic, they decided to ask me if I can become the captain. I agreed to it. But apparently at the third day of the Titanic, I was sleeping, and then we hit something and I woke up and I didn't know what was going on, and then so I came over to the captain's quarters and said, what's happening? And apparently here was the problem. The ship crashed into an iceberg. And then we only had an hour or two, according to the creator of the ship. And we were sinking. And then I told my men to get on the boats, and then I was left behind because it was my fault. I wasn't even steering at the ship, and it was all my fault, so I had to stay on the ship. So while I was sailing, trying to go to a safety point, apparently the Titanic was sinking, and the water reached to the captain's quarters. I drowned, and I used my coat to try to keep myself warm, but apparently it was the curtain ring down then the stage on me. And then I decided to, when, before that happened, I've been saying hi to people, I've been helping out the family members that I love, and I also helped out the friends and family. That's my presentation.
Abraham Lincoln was born in Kentucky. He grew up on a farm. Abe loved to read books and learn. He was the 16th president. He did not want anyone to be a slave. He passed a law that ended slavery. Abraham Lincoln was shot in the back of the head. He was at the play when he got shot. He died